This video is on the topic of energy stores and energy transfers. Everything that happens in the universe involves an energy transfer. Whenever there is a change in a system, energy is transferred. When the pendulum swings, energy is transferred from the kinetic store to the gravitational potential store, and back to the kinetic store, and then back to the gravitational potential store, and so on. The total amount of energy in the system is constant, but the energy is being transferred from store to store within the system. Energy is stored in objects in different energy stores. Moving objects have energy in their kinetic store. When they stop moving, energy is transferred away from the object. When objects are raised through a gravitational field, energy is transferred to their gravitational potential store. When the object falls, energy is transferred away from the object. Energy is stored in the chemical bonds of substances. When chemical reactions occur, energy is transferred to or away from the chemical energy store of the system. When an object is squashed or stretched, this is sometimes also called strain, energy is transferred to its elastic potential store. When the object is released, energy is transferred away from the object. Energy is stored in the electrostatic energy store of charged particles. When those charged particles are attracted to or repelled by other charged particles, energy is transferred. Energy is stored in the magnetic energy store of magnets and magnetic materials. When magnets are attracted to or repelled by other magnets, energy is transferred. Energy is stored in the nuclear energy store of atomic nuclei. When nuclei are split in nuclear fission, energy is transferred. And when nuclei are joined in nuclear fusion, energy is transferred. Energy is also stored in the thermal energy store of objects due to their temperature. When an object is heated, energy is transferred to the thermal store of the object. When an object is cooled, energy is transferred away from the thermal store of the object. You do need to remember all the names of the energy stores and be able to apply them to the context given in a question. Let's take a look at an example exam question. A battery-powered drone at rest on the ground flies vertically upwards and hovers in the air. State the energy transfers taking place, and it's worth 3 marks. Let's make sure we understand the scenario. The drone is initially at rest on the ground. At rest means that it's stationary, it's not moving. The system here is defined as the drone flying vertically upwards from its stationary position and hovering there. So we need to identify the energy transfers taking place just for that piece of motion. The 3 marks are an indication that we're looking to name 3 energy stores. The command word here is state. It's tempting to think that that means you just have to name the 3 energy stores, but be careful. The question is state the energy transfers taking place. In any transfer, there is a store that energy is being transferred from and a store that energy is being transferred to. So firstly, where is the energy being transferred from? Energy is transferred from the chemical store of the battery in the drone. That's the first mark. The words that are underlined in a mark scheme mean that you have to say that bit in exactly that way to get the mark. So where is that energy being transferred to? Well, the drone starts moving, so that's the kinetic store, and that's the second mark. What's next? The drone flies vertically upwards, so it's gaining height. Therefore, energy is transferred to its gravitational potential store, and that's the third mark. Notice in this example that the energy transfers taking place are between different stores in the same object, the drone. And that's okay. Sometimes students think it must be wrong if the energy transfer is not from object to object, but it totally can be. It all depends on the context. Let's have a look at another example where students often think it must be wrong. A person holds a mug of hot coffee. They feel their hands getting warmer. State the energy transfers taking place. And this time it's 2 marks. So again, we ask, where is the energy being transferred from? Well, it's the hot coffee, right? The coffee is in the mug. So there must be an energy transfer going on to cause the mug to heat up. And then there must be another energy transfer that causes the hands to heat up. So energy is transferred from the thermal store of the coffee, that's the first mark, to the thermal store of the mug, that's the second mark, to the thermal store of the hands, that's another mark. Sometimes mark schemes are structured so that you can gain the marks by saying any combination from several answers. So here you would get both marks for saying any two of these three things. Notice in this question how the energy stores are all the same. This is another example of when students think it must be wrong, but it's not. Energy is being transferred between the same energy store, the thermal store, but the energy is being transferred from object to object to object. In summary, energy is transferred between energy stores. That could be different stores in the same object, or the same stores in different objects, or even different stores in different objects. When answering questions, make sure you always say where the energy is being transferred from and where it is being transferred to. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.